Now we'll attempt to solve absolute value equations using the graphing calculator. To do this, we're going to set the left side of the equation equal to y sub 1, and we'll set the right side of the equation equal to y sub 2. So graphically, we'll try to determine when y sub 1 is equal to y sub 2. So we'll press y equals, and for y1, we'll type in the absolute value of 2x plus 3. Then we'll press math, right arrow once to number, and the first option here is ABS for absolute value. So we'll press enter, and then 2x plus 3, close parenthesis, and then y2 is equal to 5. So we'll go ahead and press zoom 6 for the standard window. There's the graph of the absolute value function, and there's the graph of the horizontal line. Notice how they intersect in two points, another reason why many absolute value equations have two solutions. So we want to determine the x-coordinates of these points of intersection, which will represent the two solutions. So we'll press second trace for calculate, and then option 5 for intersection. We'll move the cursor closer to the point we want to find first. It can only find one point at a time. And now I'm going to press enter for the first curve, enter for the second curve, and enter for the guess. And notice how it's telling us the x-coordinate of this point of intersection is x equals negative 4, which is one of our solutions. We'll go ahead and write that down. And now we'll go back and find the second solution. So we'll do the same thing. We'll press second trace, option 5. Move the cursor close to the second point of intersection. And then enter, enter, enter. And now we have x equals 1. So our solutions are x equals negative 4 or x equals 1. And hopefully graphically you can see now why many absolute value equations have two solutions. If you have a V-shaped graph and a horizontal line, many times they will intersect in two points, giving us two solutions. Now let's take a look at the second equation. We're going to do the same thing. We'll let y1 equal the left side and y2 equal the right side. And then we'll see if graphically we can determine when these two graphs are equal to each other or when they intersect. Now you might notice something special about this equation, but let's go ahead and take a look at the graph. So we'll press y equals. We'll go ahead and clear these again and just start from the beginning. So again, we're going to press math, right arrow once, and then enter for absolute value. And then we'll type in 2 minus 3x, close the parenthesis, press enter, and then y2 is equal to negative 5. We'll go ahead and press graph. And notice there's our V. But notice how the horizontal line is below the V and there are no points of intersection. This is what it looks like graphically when there are no solutions to an absolute value equation. And you may have recognized this from the beginning because we know absolute value is always positive, so there's no way this absolute value could be equal to negative 5. So I think taking a look at absolute value equations graphically is another way to better understand what's happening when we have two solutions or when there's no solution. I hope you found this helpful.